Hey YouTube, this is Jayden coming at you in Team Shadow Strike, and in this deck profile, I'm going to be bringing you a Angel Feather deck profile. So a couple of things I want to talk about before I get into the deck profile. First off, there is a couple of decks here that I have that I'm going to show off to you guys. I have a analysis of the upcoming set for you guys I'm also going to film, as well as a couple of other videos that I want to make and talk about. One of them will be a meta-analysis, sort of, kind of, and then the other one will be a discussion video. But, as always, guys, I always tell you, if you have a certain video you want to see, please feel free to share it with me. I always like to hear your guys' suggestions ahead of time for these next upcoming videos. My voice is a little scratchy. It's because the allergy season is starting up, and it always hits me like a ton of bricks. So, anyway, guys, I guess we'll jump into this. This is the rescue build. I originally was not going to build Angel Feather. at least I wasn't going to until they did something about Refros, because when Refros originally was running around, that deck to me was a complete stall deck. And by stall, I meant if you go to big events, people find ways to work the clock, we'll say, and I had seen and personally seen people use the Refros loop, not loop essentially, but it can be if you get the right setup, and just use Refros to sit there and increase their power and stall for time, and I wasn't going to be a part of that, but I did decide that I wanted to build this because it is fun. It's not my favorite deck to play, but it's also really fun to play. I don't know if I ever will take this to a major event. It's not, it is fun to play, I will admit. It's extremely annoying for your opponent to deal with if you get the right board and setup. But, I'll show you my take on the deck, and I'll explain my choices. This is, like I said, it's a rescue build. It is not a no-seal build. I do not use the Grade 3 no-seal and the no-seal stride. I prefer the rescue, abusing the rescue mechanic, because if you're talking about the game mechanics that have been introduced for all the clans, rescue is easily one of the top five. So anyway, guys, let's jump straight into this deck profile. I normally have my Vanguard mat, but I left that at my friend's place, and I won't be getting that back until tomorrow. So we're just gonna have to rock it with the Mewtwo's. So hopefully you like Mewtwo. So for the starting Vanguard is Black Candle Azreal. This is the original starter that came out when Angel Feather got their first support back in GBT04. Well, not their first support, but their updated support for the Stride era. So her skill is Forerunner. When you ride on top of her with a grade 1, you can slide her out. And then her skill is GB1. Counterblast 1 and place this unit in the soul, then put the top card of your deck into the damage zone face up, and then you can choose a card from your damage zone and put it into your hand. So this gives you another way to grab another card out of the damage zone in case there's something in there like a perfect guard or a heal trigger that you want to put into your hand for guarding or a G-Guardian. So I like this better than the Rescue Starter. The Rescue Starter's good. I just prefer this because it gives me more access to the damage zone, and if you're going to be playing Angel Feather, you might as well abuse that you can grab things out of the damage zone, and that's Angel Feather's best mechanic, so I see that as the better reason to play this card, because then you're abusing what it makes them so good, so I go with this. So. And then for triggers, we got our four Gabrielle Heart Thump clones, which is Mooncar, so 4 crits, goes to the soul of a Gabriel, plus 5, draw a card. 3 critical hit Angel for 3 more crits for 7 crits total. Basic Margul effect, place her in the soul, give plus 3k to a unit of your choice. You actually do use your soul quite a bit, and because there is, let's see, one of your grade 3s uses it, one of your strides uses it, so it you will need soul. Actually, 2 of your strides use it, so all these go on the soul and help you with that, but, so, 7 crits. Next we play, 4, Surgery Angel. This is Stand Trigger. This is actually probably my favorite trigger in the deck, honestly, because this you can actually kind of do a little bit of a loop with this if you get your deck thin enough, if you manage to hold on to these. I really like this Stand Trigger because you can use it to boost on your first attack, shove it back in the deck, and then get fortunate to either check another one or even the same one. I guess technically there's no way to really know that, but unless you mark the card. But anywho, you can then use this to stand up the unit and attack it again. And it's really, really evil because there have been times where I've gotten six attacks off with this build and in testing. And it's really evil when Angel Feather can attack six times because this is not Aqua Force. This is Angel Feather. So there's that. And the last one is we play one Doctroid Refros. I have no problem playing this card at one, but it's a good card. That's why it's hit at one, and that's why it's it got hit, because you could just sit there and loop this card and not loop it, stall. I mean, to me, because unless you had another one in your hand, but normally when you started that thing, you had at least two or three of these in your hand. So I guess technically it is a loop. But anyway, you know what I mean. The ability to reset your damage, place those two cards in the damage zone, power up your front row, because if you had Broken Heart on the field, they're going to kick multiple times. It was a unhealthy thing for the game. But playing this at one, you should still do it. You don't technically have to play it anymore, but it is still a good card. It lets you take two cards from your damage zone, put them back into the deck, shuffle, draw a card, and then put the two cards back into the damage zone. That you got to replace the damage that you put in the deck, and then you get to draw a card. So you can put triggers back into your deck. You can put good cards back into your deck, and then you also get a card to replace it. So you don't lose anything, but it's just kind of there. It's not really that big of a problem anymore. And next, our four heal triggers are Sunny Smiles. Sunny Smile Angel, this card still averages like $10 plus a hit, and I have no idea why. Because we're in the format now where G-Guardians are a thing, so it's very rare. I mean, I think I did it once in all of testing, where I opened up with two of these and I sent one back to the deck. It's not very common where you see people call this anymore, boost and put it back in the deck, because generally they're going to hold on to it for a G-Guardian later, but it's an option, so I guess I can understand that, but... So, seven crits, four stands, four heals. Seven crits, five stands, four heals, my bad. Grade ones, we're playing four copies of Black Record is Raphael, I think is how you say her name, which is your Angel Feather G-Perfect. I do have the rescue ones. I do not... You counterblast a fair amount in this deck using Gabrielle, your strides. I just like having access to this so I can unflip. The Rescue Perfect is good, I'm not denying that, because if you can get one in your damage zone and set it up, it's really good, but I just prefer this. So it's mainly a player preference. For Gabrielle, Searchers and Stride, or Stride Fodder, whatever you want to call them, this is a stride deck. That's what Angel Feather, you know, that's what you're going to be doing with this deck, so you want to max out on your opportunities to stride. And I only play seven grade threes in this deck, and you always want to ride Gabrielle every single time, so you use this to search out Gabrielle if you don't have her. Next, we play three copies of Black Bomber Malik. So her skill is she's a really good card. When this unit is placed on rear guard from your damage zone until end of turn, this unit gets Rescue 1. Rescue 1, GB1. At the end of the battle that this unit attacked or boosted, if that battle is a battle that a Vanguard was a... I never noticed that. The wording on this card is atrocious. I'll start over. When this card is placed on the rear guard from the damage zone, it gets Rescue 1, GB1. At the end of the battle that this unit attacked or boosted and it was directed at a Vanguard, choose a card from your damage zone, heal it, and choose one of your Vanguards and deal one damage. So you get a rescue check, so you can possibly restand a unit, get a heal, or power up a Vanguard and give it a crit. So, it's good. This card is really good. I would even consider playing it at 4, but it is good at 3. And then, going on to the last grade one is we're playing 3 copies of Battlekeep and No-Seal. I know I said I do not play the No-Seal grade 3, and I do not play the No-Seal Stride, but I do not agree playing this at 4. I started out at 2, I put it at 3, and at 3 sometimes this card's just kind of a hindrance. I really wanted to test this, but I, for whatever reason, cannot find one more copy of this card. It's not the end of the world. I mean, this does work, and drawing this in the early game is not bad because you can shut off a lot of attacks in the early game, which is 5 or 10k worth of shield, and you can use this, like if your Gabrielle goes to your damage zone in the early game, you can use this to fetch it. So, it has its advantages. It's just, I would never max out on this card. I just don't believe in it. So, that's grade ones. Grade twos. We play 4 copies of Nurse of Broken Heart. I'm assuming everybody knows what this does. This is the best grade 2 that Angel Feather has. It's arguably the best card in the deck. Except for maybe Gabrielle. Basically, when a card is placed into the damage zone, she is going to get plus 2,000 power, and she also gets plus 2,000 power to the Vanguard. So you can stack your defense up real high on your opponent's turn and make it harder for them to hit Gabrielle, and that can be extremely frustrating for your opponent. So, for Broken Heart, this card, I think, speaks for itself. It is by far the best grade 2 in the deck, if not the best card. Next, we play 3 copies of Black Slice Harut. This card is, some Angel Feather players I have noticed have been cutting it, or maybe they'll shrink the number they play considerably. I still personally like Harut because there are times where you might just not have a good field set up, and she can kind of save you a little bit, and I like being able to correct the field. So whenever this unit attacks the Vanguard, GB1, you can, and she is boosted, you may counterblast 1. If you do look at the top 2 cards of your deck, search for 1 card among them, put it into your damage zone face up, put the rest on the bottom of your deck, and choose a face up card from your damage zone and call it to the rear guard circle. So you can use this to call cards out of your damage zone that you would put, that were put there, that you'd rather have on the field. So, she is good. I like her, but as a 3 of, I don't think I'd max out at 4. Next, 3 copies of Black Relief Aratoron. I personally really like this card. It actually has come in pretty clutch for me in a couple of times in testing. GB1, when your card is put into the drop zone from the damage zone due to the effect of the rescue ability, you can counterblast 1. If you do, call the card that was put into the drop zone to another rear guard is in the same column as this unit. So if you perform a rescue check and you put the card, and when that card goes to the drop zone, if she is on the rear guard, you can counterblast 1 and call that unit into her, the same column as her. So you can either call it behind her or you can call it over her. It's good because it's another way to fetch units. It's kind of Fenrir-esque because you're in the way that Fenrir calls things when they're removed from the soul and sent to the drop zone. Aratoron calls them when they're sent from the damage zone to the drop zone. So it's pretty cool, actually. I personally really like this card. I like comboing it. If I have one of those rescue stand triggers, Surgery Angel, and rescuing that one and then calling that to here, and then when then that is a column, and then that stand's going to go back to the deck. So I personally really like that. And then for the last grade 2 is I play 2 Million Ray Pegasus. I do not play the grade 1 Pegasus because I just don't feel it's needed anymore, because this boosts your front row enough and you have rescue to give you more power anyway. I do like Million Ray as a ride for your grade 2 because of his ability, and it can kind of stop rushing, because if This is your Vanguard, and your opponent calls three units to try and rush you down a little bit. If they attack you once and you hit a damage trigger, he goes from 9 to 11 because a card was put into the damage zone plus another 5, and he becomes 16. So he can be a little he's kind of like a better version of a 10K for Angel Feather, because he gains that 2K bonus each time a card is put into the damage zone, and if you give the power to the trigger effect to him too, he goes from 9 to 16. And when your opponent's on grade 2, that is a little more hard for them to hit, and it can really save you and not make you take a lot of damage early on, which you do not want to do with this deck. You really want to stay like at 2-3 if you can before you go into Gabrielle. I've found it is the best way that the deck works for me. But anyway, so it's grade 2s. Grade 3s, obviously, we play 4 copies of Black Shiver Gabrielle. So, Gabrielle is, do not let her angelic look fool you. This angel is a bitch with a capital bitch. She is arguably the most dominant female card in Vanguard. Actually, I think she is the best female card in Vanguard right now. She is just an absolute nightmare for your opponent to deal with on their turn, especially if they start triggering, if they start damaging you and you start damage checking, as well as having her GB2 active. She can get real big real quick. If your GB2 is active and you have just one Broken Heart and you damage one card, and if both of these are on the field, she's going to go from 11, plus 2 from this, plus 2 from this, she becomes 15. If the card you damage checked to get that power was a trigger, she goes from 11 to 20. And the number from the magic number to hit her goes from 16 to 25. And in other words, the magic number being your opponent, making to where your opponent has to get over that to make you ditch at least 10K from your hand. So it's very hard to deal with that. So Gabrielle is amazing. And then obviously her stride skill. When you stride on her, you can counterblast one. Look at the top 3 cards of your deck and search for one card among them. Place that card into the damage zone face up. Put the other 2 cards that you grabbed off the top with her skill to the bottom of the deck. And then you can call one card from the damage zone that's face up to the field, and it gains 2,000 power until end of turn. So it's she can get you more rear guards, and she carries defense. She is the reason this deck works. So, and then for the other grade 3, we play 3 copies of Black Devotee Fall Egg. So Fall Egg. She came out in GBT09, and I really like this card, actually. Her ability, Rescue 1, Act. GB1 activates from the damage zone. If this card is face up, call this card to the rear guard circle. It gets plus 2,000 power until end of turn, and put the top card of your deck into your damage zone face down. Choose a card from your damage zone, heal it, and choose one of your vanguards and deal 1 damage. So if she's face up, you can counterblast 1. Call her to a rear guard circle, then take the top card of your deck and place it face down in the damage zone, and then perform a rescue check. So she does have a way of coming out to the battlefield to give you another attacker, which is really good. And then her other skill is Soul Blast 1. When this card is discarded from your hand to pay the cost for stride, you may Soul Blast 1. If you have a Vanguard with the rescue ability, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose a card from your damage zone and heal it. So, really, really good, actually. So, she is a nice complement to Gabrielle and the rescue engine. So, that is the main deck. And for the strides, there are 2 proxies in here, but that's because they are in other decks, so I will explain what they are. So for the first card, we are playing the stride from GBT09 that is was the push for me to build this deck, because I actually really, really like this card. And that is 4 copies of Holy Seraph Altiel. Altiel is the first stride that Angel Feather was really looking for, in my opinion, because you want a stride that lets you flip something else up so you can get the GB2 skill on Gabrielle activated as soon as possible. And the one that you got in Fighter's Collection, Zacrial or whatever it is, I personally don't like that card. All it does is give you plus 3k to the front row, and I prefer having the rescue check. That's just me. Now, Zacriel, if you have 5 cards in the damage zone, she gains 10,000 power on top of giving 3k to the front row. That's good, but I don't like having to wait for that. Altiel just is a lot better, in my opinion. So, Altiel, her first skill, GB3, which I actually have used a time or two. Counterblast 1, all units in your front row get plus 2,000 power until end of turn. There was actually one game in testing where I had 4 damage open, and my opponent had a small hand, and they were at, like, 3 or 4 damage. I just went, you know what, fuck it, and counterblasted all of it and gave my front row 8k. And I was just like, you know what, I'm also fixing to perform some rescues. I'm just gonna go ham. And, so, it can work sometimes, just, you know, be conservative. I wouldn't do that, you know, every single time, but, if you do need that little extra power to hit the next magic number, it's nice to have that option. And it powers up the entire front row, which is even better. And then her other skill, Rescue. Counterblast 1 and Soul Blast 1. Choose a face-down card from your G-Zone and turn it face-up. When this unit is placed on the Vanguard, you may pay the cost. If you do, choose up to the same number of cards from your damage zone as there are face-up. Holy Seraph, Altiel in your G-Zone and heal them. Choose one of your Vanguards, and for each damage healed with this effect, deal 1 damage. So, the first time you go into Altiel, you're going to flip Altiel. You're only going to get to rescue 1 card. But then the next time you go into Altiel, you can rescue 3. So, it's really, really, really good. So, it's good. It's devastating, actually, especially if you have Broken Heart on the field. You're going to really increase your power by a lot. So, and remember, since she says it's on the Vanguard, so her skill activates when she rides when she strides. It now, since you stride, you can choose which skill to activate first, whether it's Gabrielle's stride skill or Altiel's skill. Usually, I'm going to activate Gabrielle's stride skill before I activate Altiel, but. You do have that option. Next, we play 4 copies of Black Seraph Gabrielle. This card helps you push when you're really trying to take definite control of the game. It is out of all the Persona strides that you know that came out, it is by far one of the most devastating, and it's very, very evil. So, Generation Break 2. Counterblast 1 and choose a face-down card called Black Seraph Gabrielle in your G-Zone and turn it face-up. Until the end of turn, this unit gets the auto skill. When your card is put into the damage zone during the battle phase, choose up to 2 of your units and they get plus 2,000 power until end of turn. Which is really good if you're using any of the cards that let you rescue check after they boost. So you're also going to gain that power as well. And then also she gets Rescue 2, Vanguard. At the end of the battle that this unit attacked, choose 2 cards from your damage zone, heal them, and choose one of your Vanguards and deal 2 damage. So you're also, after she attacks, you're going to be able to Rescue 2 and do 2 more damage to yourself to possibly hit more triggers and power up even more, plus the extra 2,000 power for each card put there. So it's you're going to be able to buff your field. Pretty amazing. She is definitely a max out in this deck. Next, we are playing only 2 copies of Holy Seraph Raphael. Now, this is where the deck gets a little tight. Some people I've seen do not max out on Altiel. I do. In all of my testing, I only ever went into Raphael once. And that's why I'm only playing 2. I'm assuming if you're watching this, you know what Raphael does. Basically, when she's on the, you can persona flip and heal 1 damage. So, because it came down to, I really still wanted to max out on Altiel because I wanted to always go in her first to get my generation break activated on Gabrielle as soon as possible. It came down to either playing for Gabrielle strides or for Raphael, and I would rather max out on Gabrielle than Raphael. so It is a good card, and I have a playset. It's just I do not feel that you need it. It is okay to play it at 2. It has not been a problem for me. If you still max out on it, you know, there's nothing wrong with that. It's just I prefer this. And then next we play one copy of Holy Seraph Raziel. Raziel is still decent. He can help you reset your damage if you kind of blow through your counterblast early, which can happen. But anyway, when this unit is placed on the Vanguard, you can Soul Blast 2. If you do, return all cards from your damage zone to your deck, shuffle your deck, and for each card returned with this effect, put the top card of your deck into the damage zone face up. So if you have Broken Heart on the field, and you place, say, 5 cards from your damage zone back into the deck, and then you put 5 back, you're going to get 10,000 power to herself and the Vanguard. So you can use him to reset your damage and kind of buff your field as another option. This is Seabreeze. This deck really needs Seabreeze, so you can at least get your Broken Heart live if your opponent wants to play the stall game. So that at least gives you that. Next, we play one copy of Holy Seraph Orphiel. This card is absolutely terrible. The only reason I'm playing it is because I only have 2 copies of Holy Seraph Suriel. This G-Guardian, in order for it to gain the extra 5k, you have to be at 4 or higher damage. I do not like that. I will be taking her out and putting in a third Suriel when I can get it. So Suriel, her ability is Counterblast 1. When this unit is placed on the Guardian Circle, Rescue 1, and then look at the... Rescue 1. When this unit is placed on the Guardian Circle, Counterblast 1. If you do, look at the top card of your deck, and then put that card on the top or the bottom of your deck. Choose a card from your damage zone, heal it, and then choose one of your Vanguards and deal it damage. So you can use this to... give your Vanguard more shield and possibly trigger check as well, so you're going to get even more. So it's essentially your 25k shield for Angel Feather. Supposedly. But it is the best G-Guardian that Angel Feather has. This card is absolutely terrible. And then for the last card, this proxy is a Dismal. Dismal for your VMAX matches to protect you from getting VMAXed and also to protect your Broken Heart. that is the G zone. So anyway, guys, that is my Gabriel Rescue deck profile. Really, really enjoy playing the deck. It is a lot of fun. It's a lot more fun than I thought. And I actually like this deck a lot more than I thought I would, too. It's very fun to play. This is still very much considered, in my opinion, a meta deck. It just because of the defensive power this carries, and it can stall out decks like crazy. Just be careful with all the rescue checks. You can deck yourself out if you're not careful. But with the power this deck can push, there are a lot of decks that just crumble to it because they can't keep up with the speed that you can power up your units if you just start rescue checking triggers like crazy. So anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching this. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think of my very first Angel deck profile, and I think forever. I don't think I've brought you an Angel Feather deck profile since I brought you Raziel Reverse. excuse me. Let me know what you think. If you have any suggestions for me, I always like to hear them. So anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching this video. Make sure you give it a thumbs up and tell me what you thought. And I will see you guys in the next one. See ya.